Hello everyone, this is Rupal Purohit and today I'm in conversation with Ragini Khanna.
Hi.
Hello, welcome to Cine Speaks.
Thank you.
And congratulations for Poshimpa. So the title Poshimpa reminds me of the childhood play Rhyme. So, and when I saw the poster, I was curious to know, like, is it literally on the rhyme? And when I saw the trailer, it was actually like the director took the literal meaning of the rhyme.
Yeah, it is the literal consequence of the game we played as kids.
Yeah. And this is your digital debut. So what came into your mind that you said yes to the script and it is a thriller?
The fact that I play anti-law, I love the script. I love the writer's work. I was extremely charmed by the director's work, or his past work. And I was looking forward to collaborate with these highly skilled professionals so that I could learn something from them. And I'm a very greedy artist, so I just like latched onto this one.
So this film is shot in just like 19 days.
Yes.
So how was it, must be difficult for you to get in such a serious character and get out of it in like very short period of time?
Yes, it's not been that tough. In fact, I'm glad this time, I'm glad it was for a very short period of time. I didn't have to suffer this character for a long time. If I had to play this part for over like 2-3 years, I would have gone mad. So, you know, it's a very, very scary headspace to be in. And I'm glad it happened quick.
So, can you please share light on your character?
I play Shikha Deshpande, who's anti-law, sociopath, a psychological serial killer, who's all black, no heart, all cerebral. She survives the law of the jungle. And yes, she has no sense of emotion. जो भी उसके रास्ते में आएगा उसको मार डालेगी।
ओह, so this is inspired from true events.
Yes.
So what like what did you take to put in your character? Like what did you learn or what did you do any kind of research to get into the character as it is real?
Of course I did. Also as since years, see it's years of work. You as an actor, as an artist, you keep prepping, and then you get that one final opportunity where you get to put your skill set on tape, on film, on chips. So you have to keep prepping for that as an artist. So I got that one opportunity is for the years of prep which I have been putting into performing arts. I completely sunk my teeth into this character. I have read, I have all my experiences and my visual whatever I have seen and grasped from whatever crime films I've seen, the crime books I have read, criminal psychology or whatever little bit I have read, why people function the way they do, why people go anti-law, what is the source of it, why do they do this? Till date, I have still not found a reason for it. And it has something to do with your cerebral bent, you know, it is, so there is no sense of psychological mapping being done on these kind of minds. Even if it is being done currently as we speak, it's a very tedious process. It's extremely case sensitive and there's no cause and effect. It's like aap khana kha rahe ho, aapne maar diya. For them it's that normal. For Shikha it's that normal. Khana khaya, murder karke aa gaye. It's like a to-do list, check.
Oh.
So to be something like that is crazy.
Also we heard that you broke down on the sets. So why? Like, was
who said it? I want to kill someone who said it. The Shikha in me is coming alive. Yes, I broke down on the set because I empathized with the situation Shikha was in. Though, if I see her as a community person, she's completely against my moral integrity value structure. But when I play her as an artist, I have become that person and I lose judgment on her. So I broke down because she has gone through extreme situations.
Was there any second thought before saying yes to the script?
Not at all.
Oh, so you were
the only thought was that how am I going to perform this?
Oh.
That's it.
Okay. How is this film, according to you, different from other thriller films?
It's a psychological thriller, we are, I'm not saying, I don't know how different we are, but I can tell you what we are. You can differentiate and distinguish and choose the content you wish to view, but you should give this a watch, because we have explored female toxicity, we have explored matriarchy gone wrong. These women are raised to kill people. So that is why you should explore it. It's, we have, in the history of our country, we've never had a woman on the death row.
Yeah.
I play a woman who's on the death row. So there are a lot of firsts. You must watch.
There is no differentiation between criminals, be it a male or a female. Criminal is a criminal. So do you think there should be proper justice, like equal justice to both, like male or female, be it male
criminal? See, cerebral capacity, cerebral... you're talking about cerebral equality over here, right? If somebody is a criminal, you are comparing cerebrally to them. You're comparing the minds. The act of crime has been committed. Act of crime has nothing, is not gender specific, is not region specific. It's nothing to do with religion. It has nothing to do with anything. It has to do with your choice of acting upon a situation which is anti-law. That's what who you are. That's who you are. And there are people who are fierce enough in rage or in whatever triggers them. They have made those choices and they become those people.
So, say according to you, it's just crime.
It has nothing to do with gender.
Yeah, because crime is crime.
Crime is crime. Murder is murder. How is it specific? It's, in fact, this is female toxicity to its extreme. Because women... See, now I'm a woman, I can speak for women. Now, if women have emotionally are far more complex than men. Men emotionally are not, like, you know, they say women multitask better, men have better physical capabilities. So we are both naturally, a man's body and a woman's body has been naturally designed to do best what their physicalities can achieve. There's no sense of equality over here physically or cerebrally. How much ever you feed the mind is going to excel, how much you're not going to feed the mind is not going to excel. It has to do with nourishment of your mind. So what was the question? I've lost.
It's okay.
What were you talking about?
I was talking about there should be an equal justice.
Yes. So you're thinking about the mind. This is about cerebral equality. So you're punishing the mind of that body.
Yeah.
You're punishing that thought process so that those acts of crime are not repeated for the safety of everybody else.
Yeah.
Keeping the communal harmony chord intact, you make those decisions, and it is not gender specific.
Correct. Moving forward, so how much excited are you for this film?
Extremely.
This is your debut film, debut digital film.
After 11 years of work, I'm debuting in digital, which is a great, great feeling. It's okay. I'm just now I'm done. I'm very happy. I've let go of all my toxicity, as you know, all my negativity. I've channelized it through Shikha. I have given it out. It has been archived. I have chosen to be archived as somebody who's all black. No emotion. So then, so be it.
Can we see you more in digital shows, like digital film you are doing? Maybe more digital shows.
Never know, yeah. If I get a good director, I will do film, television, digital. I need a good director. I need a good writer. That's my prerequisite. That's it.
Lastly, any project coming up next?
Filhal to Poshampa, 21st August, Z5. Please watch.
Okay, thank you so much. It was a nice conversation with you.
Thank you.